With Sweet Home Season 2 providing an ending that most certainly looked like there was more in the works, and the show even announcing that there's going to be a new season arriving in 2024, it's good to know that there's definitely more that's on the way. But with it finishing on a cliffhanger, it got me wondering about what could happen when the show does eventually return. So with that, I thought I'd take a look at all that's out there, along with giving my theories and predictions on what I think could happen next. So let's get into it. Here is Sweet Home Season 3, Everything We Know. Just to let you know, this video will contain spoilers. The release date. Well, the good news is, we know that a third season is definitely on the way, and it's already been filmed. During the final episode of Season 2, there was text that appeared on the screen which said how Season 3 of the show will be returning in the summer of 2024. Meaning, unlike most shows, it's following a slightly different formula. We waited a couple of years between Season 1 and Season 2, and this time we only have to wait a handful of months, which is a positive. When the show was commissioned for a Season 2 and a Season 3 at the same time, they decided to film the entire batch of episodes in one go, meaning that despite the fact it was an intense filming schedule, they managed to get everything completed. Production for the show finished in around March of this year, so they've had plenty of time to work on the post-production side of things. I would say that because of the cliffhanger at the end of Season 2 and the weight that it has to the story, I imagine that they wanted to keep the momentum of the show going so that it still had that rhythm and excitement when it did return, rather than leaving it for years before eventually coming back. So the main takeaway here in terms of the release date is that there's not that long to wait at all. And before then, we'll most probably get a teaser trailer and a full-blown official trailer that will be coming our way. The story. So in terms of the plot, there are multiple different directions that this next season could go in, and it's all split amongst the different story arcs that we've got developing separately. Whilst Season 2 was a tad disjointed due to the long run times and the fact that some of the stories weren't 100% fleshed out, I feel we'll see them all start to connect in this next season of the show, and they will progress forward as one. One of the major storylines that I feel we're going to be seeing getting developed is focused around Yi Kyung's daughter, Ahi, who is a hybrid human monster and is able to not only communicate and lead the monsters, but she can also turn any human that she wants to into one, whilst kneeling to her command, a power which is extremely advantageous for her. With her growing up and being locked away and told that she was some kind of enemy to the humans, and with her also being hunted by humans in the past due to being different, I feel we'll see that pent-up resentment and anger start to come out, and we could see her turn on half of her own kind. The monsters have shown her much more kindness than the humans ever have, and I think that will be something which will take center stage, as the humans may be fighting a war on that front, but also on another. There's a lot of mystery about the character, her importance, and what the lengths of her powers actually are, so I think we'll see more of that being developed too. She's clearly a powerful individual, but how powerful is she? The other arm of the story which I think will be getting developed will be the section which concluded with Sergeant Park being restrained by the young girl and the mystery man in the suit. It's clear to see that there's something that's going on there when it comes to turning people into monsters deliberately, and also there were loads of those sacks which birth out monsters, with Yong-seok mentioning how the people in charge of the facility had no intention of letting them go. It very much feels like they've got the intention of building some kind of large monster army that will look to take over the area. Tying back to what was mentioned earlier on, how humans could be the monsters and the real monsters could be the vaccine. Sang-wook was the reason as to why all of the monsters were let out of their cells in Episode 3. So after dealing with Dr. Lim in the season finale, he could return to his post, and we could see the vital role that he's going to be playing and the seeking of revenge that he wants to get on the humans. As well as this, Eun-hyuk was the final thing that we saw before the season drew to a close. The entirety of Season 2 was focused around Eun-yu looking for her brother and questioning if he was still alive. However, with it seeming as though he was birthed from one of those sacks and it looking like he was in the same state as what Miss Im was in Episode 2, I don't think he's going to be the brother that she recognizes when she does eventually lay eyes on him. He may not have his memories, mannerisms, or human behaviors like before. So I think Eun-yu will be doing all that she can to get her brother back from the depths of the monster that lies within. One other major part of the story that I think will be getting developed will be the exposure of Eun-hwan and Chief G, both leaders of different areas of the stadium, but both have secrets that are being hidden. I think we're going to see Eun-hwan commit some kind of massacre inside of the stadium. We kept hearing about and seeing how the monster was taking over his mind, and also reminding him of when he slaughtered his family. So I think that type of aggression is going to be replicated within the stadium. He was on the cusp of changing throughout the entirety of the season, and I think it will finally happen. This will be something that will quite literally split the survivors group, and it will probably cast them all outside of the safe haven of the walls of the stadium, meaning that the monsters that will be roaming freely on both sides from the facility, but also under the control of Ahi, will have free rein on what to do, and the intelligence that is forming within them will allow them to have the upper hand. I think it's going to take a particular set of monsters, most probably hybrid, that have human inside of them, which will need to empathize with the vulnerability that the humans have, and will ultimately go on to assist them in battles that they'll be facing. That's the humans' only real hope. With regards to Hyunsu, we saw that he was buried beneath the monster form of himself, something which showed a completely different side to him. He wasn't allowing the human to come out, so I wonder if with the monster being at the forefront, how long it will alter the character for. There are so many different directions that the show could go in, and I definitely feel like there's a lot more that it's got to offer. I feel the divide between the humans and monsters is going to be larger than ever in terms of hostility, but the contact between them will be something which is far more apparent than we've ever seen, due to there being monsters at all fronts. The characters. In terms of the cast members and the characters, there were a fair few major deaths in season 2 of the show, so it will definitely impact the characters that will be featured in season 3. With the closing moments focusing on Eunhyuk, he will definitely be returning, and Eunyu will be too. With Hyunsu being the face of the show and the main character, I expect we'll see him as well. Plus, I also think that we'll see Sangwook, the mysterious child who can turn humans into monsters with a single touch, Ahi, Chan Yong, Hani, Sergeant Park, Chief G, In-hwan, and potentially Dr. Lim, depending on if San-won got his revenge and if it was in the form of death. As well as that, most of the supporting cast, such as Chief G's children, the survivors inside of the stadium, the mysterious man in the suit at the end, and the young child that was with him will probably be returning too, along with many of the monsters that we've come to be used to seeing over the course of the 2 seasons of the show. Plus, I imagine there'll most likely be more survivors that are out there that we'll come to find and uncover as the season develops on. With the likes of Yi Kyung becoming a monster, it's uncertain if she'll emerge from the depths that she fell into, but I have a feeling that we could see her again. Her worst nightmare was becoming a monster, and she ultimately became one. So I wonder if we'll see her re-emerge and witness the suffering that she's enduring. Plus, with Jisoo being crushed, she most certainly won't be returning. Unfortunately for now, that's all that's known about Sweet Home Season 3. I'm sure more information will be released as time goes on. Thankfully, we know another season is on the way, and there's not that long to wait. So, there you have it, Sweet Home Season 3, Everything We Know. If you want to see more videos such as Endings Explained, Theories and Predictions, and Character Breakdowns, then click on the card in the top corner. Or alternatively, you can head over to my channel where you'll find them all. What do you think will happen in Season 3? Leave a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.